Hello students, look at this question. It's actually a very good question, a highly theoretical question based on what happens to energies of different particles in a traveling or a standing wave. I would recommend first you read the question, you read all the options first thoroughly and think about it yourself. Okay, now let's continue. I'll explain first in case of a traveling wave and then in case of a standing wave what exactly is happening. So obviously to explain this, I'll take help of the Desmos graph graphing calculator. Okay, I really recommend you should use this software to learn anything in mathematics and anything in waves. Okay, if you want to learn waves, this is the best tool. Okay, you can experiment with all types of equations possible in case of waves. Now, so we have a wave traveling over here. First, I will discuss what is happening in case of a traveling wave, right? So first of all, let's again look at the screenshot of the wave. So look over here, I have taken a screenshot of a wave. Now let's observe some sections of the string. Okay, so I will look at various sections of the string that are of the same length. All right, I will look at various sections of the string. See, I'm taking the same length for each of them. Okay, so that you can understand them clearly. Now first of all, observe this. This is the original length of this section of the string. I could write this original length to be equal to, let's say, dx. D is obviously a small change in x. Okay, so this is the original length, and because of the wave, this element has been stretched. Now because of the stretching, it will store some potential energy. Okay, but at the same time, what is happening? This particle is basically oscillating up and down, right? Because of the wave motion. Right, every particle in case of a wave motion is performing SHM, it is oscillating up and down. So right now this particle is coming downwards, so we could say that this particle has some velocity as well. Okay, so because of the velocity, it will have some kinetic energy, right? So this particle had original length like this, but now it is stretched, so it has got some potential energy. But at the same time, because of the velocity, it is having kinetic energy. So it has some potential energy as well as some kinetic energy. Now look at the particle that is on the amplitude. This is the original length, and observe over here, the length has not changed, right? Original length and the length in this position both are equal, so this particle has not stretched, there is no potential energy. Also, right now this particle is at the amplitude, and in SHM at the amplitude velocity is zero, so this particle right now has zero velocity. So this has right now zero kinetic energy, zero potential energy. Clear? Now you got something, right? That if you are at the amplitude, you have zero potential and zero kinetic, but if you are not at the amplitude, you will have potential plus kinetic energy. And when you are at the mean position in SHM, at mean position velocity is maximum. So for this particle, kinetic energy is maximum. And if you look at the potential energy, here the amplitude is max. Here the slope is maximum. So the length of the particle has changed to the maximum over here. Here the change in length is less. Here the change in length is more. So here the potential energy is also maximum. So for traveling wave, we can learn two things. For traveling wave, we can learn two things. Ke and Pe both are equal. Then actually we should say three things. Ke and Pe are maximum at mean position, that is in the case of this particle. And Ke and Pe are zero. I'll write equal to zero at amplitude. This is what is happening, right? Now regarding the potential energy, let me give you a little visualization. So all I will do is I will add a condition over here for some particle. Let's say we take the particle between x equal to 1 and x equal to 1.1. So we are only observing a particle between x equal to 1 and 1.1, and observe. Look at this. Let me slow down the motion. Observe how the length of the particle is changing. Interesting, right? At the amplitudes, its length is again becoming normal, regular length. Let me show you. Yeah, I cannot stop it any more further. So see, this length is almost to equal to its natural length, right? But as it is going downwards, see, the length of the particle has increased, so its potential energy is increasing. Okay, length is increasing and potential energy is decreasing. When length is decreasing, potential energy is decreasing. So at amplitude zero, potential energy at mean position, length is increasing to maximum, so potential energy is maximum. Now also observe the velocity. At the it is performing basically SHM, right? So at the amplitudes, velocity is zero. At the mean position, velocity is maximum. So this is how your kinetic and potential energy will be changing. Now let's look at the points related to traveling wave. This is saying that energy of any small part of a string remains constant in a traveling wave. Wrong. At the amplitudes, energy is zero. So this option is wrong. We will mark it wrong. Look at this point. Energies of all the small parts of equal length are equal in a traveling wave. Now, if you talk about instantaneously, right? Then like I told you, this particle is right now zero potential and kinetic energy, but this particle has maximum potential as well as kinetic energy. So all the particles don't have the same amount of energy at any given moment. So option C is wrong. Clear? Now we will understand what happens in case of standing wave. So in case of standing wave, also remember this logic. When you are at the amplitude, kinetic energy is zero. At the mean position, kinetic energy is maximum. And when you go up and down, okay, like if the element is changing its length, then it will store potential energy. If the element is in its original length, then there is no potential energy. But now let's look at in this case, in the case of standing wave. So now look at a standing wave over here. This is your equation of a standing wave, right? It is just oscillating up and down. There is no traveling motion happening. Again, we look at a single particle. Okay, so I'll create a filter over here. We will look at only a particle between x equal to 1 and x equal to 1.1. Observe this. Oh, wait. We will look at this is a particle somewhere in between. So, if you observe something, look at the length of the particle, how it is changing. At the amplitudes, its length is maximum, so potential energy is maximum. But at the amplitudes, velocity is zero, so kinetic energy is zero. So if you remember, this case is becoming different as compared to a traveling wave. In traveling wave, your potential and kinetic energy are changing together. But in case of a standing wave, there is a slight variation. When the particle is passing through the mean position, its length is equal to the original length, okay, and it is having velocity. So there is no potential energy, but there will be kinetic energy. But at the amplitudes, the length has increased. Okay. So potential energy has increased, but there will be no kinetic energy. So here the case is slightly different. Now this was the point that I took somewhere in between a node and an antinode. Now let's observe what happens to a particle at the node. So a node will be obtained where sine x equal to 0. So for that we will take x equal to 0, right? So let me take a filter around x equal to 0. So I will take minus 0.05 less than equal to x less than equal to 0.05. And wait. Yeah. Now observe what is happening to the particle at a node. It is not moving at all. It does not have any kinetic energy. But its length is continuously changing. Right, its length is continuously changing. So when it is horizontal, its length is equal to the original length, so zero potential energy. But when it is tilted, its length is increasing, so its potential energy is increasing. So this particle at the node never has got any kinetic energy, but its potential energy is definitely changing. Okay, so this is what is happening for a particle at the node. Okay, now I will take a particle at antinode. So where will you find an antinode where sine x equal to 1? That is, we will take x equal to pi by 2. So I will take a filter around pi by 2, right? So I will write down over here pi by 2. So if you observe, pi by 2 minus 0.05 less than equal to x less than equal to pi by 2 plus 0.05. So now we have a node. And observe what is happening to the antinode. If you observe the particle at the antinode is never changing its length. So it is never having any potential energy. It only has kinetic energy while passing through the mean position. At the amplitudes, its kinetic energy becomes zero. And as it is leaving the amplitudes, its kinetic energy is increasing. At the mean position, kinetic energy is maximum. Then again decreasing. And again at the negative amplitude, it becomes zero. So its kinetic energy is changing. But since its length is never changing, length is always same, it is always horizontal. So its potential energy is always zero. So this is the case happening in case of a standing wave, okay? So now coming to the options, energy of any small part of a string remains constant in a standing wave. Is it correct? No. If you talk about antinode, at the amplitudes, its energy is zero. At the mean position, it has maximum kinetic energy. So this option is wrong. Look at this option now. The energies of all small parts of equal length are equal in a standing wave. This option is what? So obviously energy is again changing, right? At any moment, all the particles don't have same energy. For example, when I told you about the standing wave, this particle near the node in this position has only potential energy but no kinetic energy. And this particle is at the amplitude, so it has zero kinetic and zero potential. So obviously they don't have equal energies. So even this option will be wrong. Oh my god, what happened? All the four options are wrong. Okay, so kindly share your thoughts on this question in the comments below, and also subscribe for more such interesting questions. Okay, bye.